be out here with the new Florida heavyweight champion, Joe Hennig, tonight. Unfortunately, Joe suffered a severe injury. Due to this injury, he's not sure when he's going to be able to compete, so he called me this morning, and he surrendered and forfeited the Florida heavyweight championship. Now, I don't like this any more than anybody else does, but as the president of Florida Championship Wrestling, next week, right here, we will have a Florida heavyweight championship match.
Now, I don't give a damn if Joe Hennig can defend the title. Hell, I don't give a damn about Joe Hennig. I was next in line for the shot. And if he's going to take the coward's way out, I guess what I'm trying to say is, I want you to award me that Florida heavyweight championship right now.
If you want to be the champion, just like everyone else, you have to earn it. And in my eyes, you have earned nothing. So you deserve nothing.
Listen, both of you, right now, hold on. I've already made a decision. As a matter of fact, next week, right here on Florida Championship Wrestling, you, Drew McIntyre, being the number one contender, will be facing the former Florida heavyweight champion, Eric Escobar, and the winner of that match will be the undisputed Florida heavyweight champion.
Josh Matthews alongside the Hall of Famer, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Dream tonight, Drew McIntyre, Eric Escobar, one-on-one for the Florida Heavyweight Championship.
Well, I think this was a match that we really wanted to see a few weeks ago. And then when all this disaster started happening, things started falling apart. But Steve Kerr, the president of FCW, is bringing it to us tonight. It's going to be a wild and crazy night. I can tell the place is packed. It's going to be a beautiful piece of work. Can I pick a winner? I don't know. I think Drew McIntyre is a hungry lion. Escobar, obviously, former champion, should be great.
Well, regardless, tonight someone will be leading with the gold.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Cleveland, Ohio, weighing 222 pounds.
Dream, Derek Bateman has headphones on.
Yeah, let me tell you a little bit about him.
Okay? Please do.
Yeah, pretty good athlete, man. But every time I go to talk to him, he's respectful, but he's got these cans on, man. So he's into his music, and he says that's just a way to get him into it and get him ready for the
now,
for the
break. Do you think he's listening to his ring music that we're hearing, or he's got something else going on?
Well, I'm sure it's all about him. I'm sure it's all about him.
Introducing him.
I was hoping we were going to get some candy tonight, and it looks like we are.
They love Bobby Sanchez, man, going around the state of Florida. When we're on tour here at FCW, it's an amazing moment. It's an amazing moment to watch this guy come out. Fans love him to death.
He gives away candy. Who doesn't love someone who gives away candy?
Well, I could say something, and I won't. This telecast being broadcast over Central Florida. It's crazy. It's great. Man, look at the crowd back here. Is this place packed or what?
It most certainly is. And everyone's here to see sweet Bobby Sanchez, especially Angela.
You know him.
You know,
yeah.
How she feels about sweet Bobby.
Yeah. When you talk about giving candy to you and me, when he gives candy to Angela, it's a little bit different. You know what I'm saying? You know the difference, don't you?
We got to keep PG. Okay,
answer me. Have you ever had a date? Speak up. Yes,
once
you have.
Twice.
You're a good-looking man. You got guns on you. I mean, you're just like you're training out of your suit.
I'm working with your personal trainer as Derek Bateman goes for a ride. Courtesy of Air Sweet Poppy Sanchez.
Yeah.
Sweet Poppy, such a big boy, and that's one way to take down someone that size.
Like I told you, you know, Bateman, man, I mean, you know, he took him down. That's a good outing for this young man. This would be an upset. You know what I'm talking about, upset? This would be one. Well, that would also be upsetting.
Bateman off the ropes and... Boom. Sweet Poppy in control right now. That is a big body to land on you, followed by the boot.
How about him as Florida heavyweight champion?
It could happen.
Yeah.
And Sweet Poppy just flattened Derek Bateman.
He put him away, buddy.
Sweet Poppy Dungeon.
Ever since Sweet Poppy left the conglomerate, it's been all smiles.
There is no one left in the conglomerate. Ah, look at this. Here we go. That's it, sweetie.
Sweet Poppy looks a little nervous.
Poppy, I just want to thank you for everything that you've done for me lately. The flowers, the candy. But I kind of have to ask, why are you doing this all for me?
You like my flower?
Of course, yeah.
You like my candy?
Yeah.
Well, my Angela, I like you.
Oh, wow.
What is going on here?
Oh, no.
This is disgusting. I'm getting off the... Ever since you two have been playing cutesy boom boom boom, I feel like I'm gonna be sick. Angela, you stole that crown from me. Of FCW if it wasn't for Sweet Poppy Sanchez. In fact, you're not the queen of FCW. I am! And if I have to go through that disgusting thing you call a boyfriend, I
will! Whoa, buddy!
It's on now!
Oh, man, it's on like a neck bone, I'm telling you. Wow! Wow.
Angela hurt enough. Rosa Mendez is obsessed with the crown.
Oh.
Sweet Poppy trying to calm Angela down. They're going to get out of here and have a nice night.
I don't know, but that was good stuff, buddy. Wow.
Well, don't any of you go anywhere. Because don't forget our main event, Drew McIntyre and Eric Escobar go one-on-one for the vacant Florida Heavyweight Championship.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing 227 pounds, Dylan Klein.
Dylan Klein, a tremendous athlete. If you don't believe me, just ask Dylan Klein.
Yeah, I was telling you, and how about Angela, man? Stepping right in there doing her job. Not only the queen, the ring announcer, a great little diva wrestler, and there she just stepped right in after she just took the whipping on, put a whipping on Rosa Mendez. Wow, she is a trooper.
Don't mess with Sweet Poppy Sanchez when Angela's around.
Introducing his opponent from Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, weighing 255 pounds.
I'm gonna tell you something about this matchup right here. These two guys need a win. Yeah. Oh, you know what I mean? But one of them's gonna walk out of here with a much needed win.
Afu, the Brazilian beast, set to go one-on-one with
what heritage Cafu has. Being the Cafaludo style, maybe you tell me about that.
Yes.
Being from Brazil, and the other guy from obviously Hollywood and Las Vegas. Points west, buddy. This is a good matchup to take a step up the ladder here at FCW for both these guys. Good job, Steve Kern.
Dylan Klein shouldn't get too wrapped up with what the fans are doing. Should concentrate on the Brazilian beast, Cafu. Cafu competed all over the United States, competed in Puerto Rico before ending up here in Florida Championship Wrestling.
Well, so you would say he's quite an international star, maybe. You
know, journeyman, perhaps.
No, that's a journeyman and international star. Like, Tiger Woods is an international star.
Yes.
Derek Bateman is a journeyman. See the difference?
I do see the difference. Good. Thank you for clarifying that for me.
There's that Kapalula kick.
I'm sorry, the what kick?
Kapalula kick. What do you call it?
If you say it fast enough, it sounds right. It's a capoeira, actually. It's a,
well, that's what I said.
Yeah, I know. I hear you. You're the American Dream Dusty Rhodes.
Hey, how about coming in here tonight? I mean, man, people lined up out front when you got out of the cab. Come in here, man. People were just trying to mob you, and you were stuck for money, and you had to get a couple of dollars. Anyway, sellout crowd packed in here. FCW Arena taking a walk. Dylan Klein.
Yeah, Dylan Klein might be taking a walk to the locker room.
No, I think he understands the importance of Leaf trying to get a victory.
Those lethal kicks from Cafu, who sends Dylan Klein back. No, Dylan Klein?
Well, that's a block. Did he block that or what?
He did with this foot there. Oh! Cafu didn't block that. And now Dylan Klein with bad intentions in mind for Cafu.
Man, what a matchup tonight for the Florida Heavyweight Championship. Just an amazing. Hey, and how about them guys last week for the tag team? Croft and
What is going on with these guys?
I mean, they left with the FCW championship, with the property of FCW. Amazing.
They stole the tag team titles.
Haven't seen them or the titles yet.
Well, somewhere around Tampa, two guys are running around with the Florida tag team titles. Snap near there by Dylan Klein.
Yeah, yeah, and I'm going to tell you something else. What a debut for that young man, Joseph Canterbury, last week. He had fear in his eyes, and when he left here, he didn't know where he was. He couldn't even pay attention. Here you go, crowd getting with this.
Trying to get behind Cafu, tries to sidestep out of there.
That'll break your arm right there. If that's done right, that will break your arm.
And Dylan Klein's been working that arm of Cafu throughout this matchup here.
Got him hooked up here.
Dylan Klein now yelling at the Brazilian Beast. Slaps across the throat.
Headbutt. He's doing that with one arm. He's doing all this with one arm.
Dylan Klein's still holding on to that arm. Not any longer. Hip toss there by Cafu. Trying to shake some feeling back into that arm. Pair of chops across the chest to the Dylan Klein. Followed up by a kick there. Cafu trying to get back in control right now.
Here you go. Coming
up. Pretty good job of it.
Wow. Pretty nice move right there.
Good habit. Solid boot. That may do it. A kick out there by Dylan Klein.
Well, like I said, both men need a win, and they need to get it right now. I'm telling you. This is pretty good out in here. Two young guys trying to step up the ladder.
Back and forth contest. Who will be victorious? Dylan Klein catches Cafu.
He's got him hooked there now.
Nice
here we go.
Throw there. A nonchalant cover.
Yeah, lazy hook. Lazy cover.
Cafu was able to escape. Maybe that's the mistake that Cafu needs from Dylan Klein. He's going for a pump handle here. Cafu slides out the back.
Long-legged kick, buddy.
This may be a formality. This one is over.
Here is your winner, Cafu.
Cafu takes one from Dylan Klein, and Dream said that someone in this match needed to pick up a victory. Maybe this is the victory that Cafu needed to springboard himself to the next level. And something right now I'm being told is happening backstage. I have a feeling that it's probably Fletcher Chase.
Let's go.
Yes?
Oh, I get it. Red and Croft. Listen, you two guys have got something that not only belongs to FCW, but belongs to the tag team champion.
Hollywood Francais.
Johnny Curtis and Tyler Rex. The championship titles, where are they? We'll give you 10 seconds. Let's have them.
This is not us.
Rex.
Yeah.
How do I look?
Well, you did look like a young Burt Reynolds.
Sweet.
All right.
Let's go.
Let's do it.
Well, that takes care of that.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by Beverly, from Washington, D.C., weighing 242 pounds, Alex Riley.
As Alex Riley makes his entrance, who do Kronk and Beretta think they're kidding?
That was off the hook. Steve Kern, I'm telling you, that was, disguised himself as Christmas. Oh.
Well, nonetheless, Rex and Curtis have their tag team titles back.
Miss Beverly, right there, Beverly and Alex Riley. They are the king and queen of the hot, buddy.
Introducing his opponent.
Quite the rivalry starting here between these two individuals, Johnny Prime and Alex Riley. And Johnny Prime does not want to wait for the opening bell.
Well, I'm going to tell you what,
it goes back to last week,
what happened. And the bottom line of this thing right here, Josh, is, we talk about just stepping up to the plate saying, I want to challenge somebody. He said, give him to me again. You know what I mean? Alex Riley, I mean, he's just one of them, frat guys, man, that just think he's better than anybody else. Johnny Prime said, well, I'm an old Florida boy, and I'm going to take it to the woodshed.
Well, last week, Alex Riley stole one from Johnny Prime, put his feet on the ropes. The referee didn't see it. So we'll see what happens here tonight as Riley goes one-on-one with Johnny Prime once again. And Beverly has the Letterman's jacket of... Wait a minute, why does Alex Riley still wear his Letterman's jacket?
Because he believes and still is taking courses at the university. He is in a fraternity.
He's still
she
in a fraternity?
She is in a sorority.
Still?
I told you all that information early in your career.
Well, what does he have a letter in?
The letter is in Alex Riley. It's an R. It's for Riley.
Did he go to the University of Alex Riley, covered by Johnny Prime, to kick out?
You know what? I'm just going to knock the snot out of you.
Another cover. Before you do that, let me tell you that Johnny Prime actually played Arena League football. Did you know that?
Yes.
All
and
right.
Before that, I would tell you Alex Riley was a quarterback also in college. So there you go.
He certainly acts like a quarterback, that's
yeah.
for sure, Johnny.
Yeah, I was going to say that. Two great athletes, same size, rivalry, heated rivalry starting to build.
Well, Alex Riley's down and out on the outside. Beverly there to make sure that her man's okay. Riley very cautiously trying to get back into the ring and shot to the midsection there of Johnny Prime and then hangs that arm up over the top rope.
Well, Alex knows what to do and how to take advantage of stuff, and that's really what has really turned everything around for him.
Well, Alex
attitude,
knows that.
Yeah,
into
attitude.
The cover goes Alex Riley. Let me ask you what you know about Beverly.
Beverly, obviously from the way it looks, man, I mean, she's right off the campus, you know what I'm saying? So I guess Alex met her somewhere, and they struck it up, and she obviously is the head of her sorority, whatever it is. I mean, I heard him talking about it earlier, what dance are you going to go to? I mean, this guy's still going to university. This guy's still going to dancing. This guy's still running frat house.
So you're looking at basically the typical frat sorority boyfriend-girlfriend relationship between Alex Riley and...
Without a doubt. And I wouldn't be surprised if her daddy did not be the dean or president of the university. You know what I'm saying?
Do you think that Alex pinned her yet?
What? That he what?
That's what they do. They put the pin on the jacket. It's a time-honored tradition.
Yeah, if he didn't pin her yet, then shame on him.
Riley goes for a cover. Johnny Prime escapes. I wonder if I'll get invited to one of these fraternity, sorority soirees.
I'm going to tell you what, they got a good matchup going on this soirée. Talking about, this week here on FCW, man. The people really behind this young kid, Johnny Prime.
Top wrist lock there by Alex Riley. Prime trying to get out of it and does. Reversal, now it's Prime off the ropes. Ducks the clothesline off the other side. Now here comes Johnny Prime ahead of steam.
Yeah.
Forearm across the face there of Alex Riley. Followed up by a back elbow and Johnny Prime in control. It is certainly prime time here in the FCW arena. Wow, that's a big boot.
Yeah, it is. He needs to capitalize right now, try to get a cover, get him in a pinning situation, and that's what it's all about. Take kind of even this thing out where it's 1-1 maybe.
Giant Prime's allowing Alex Riley time to recover here and get to his feet. Going for that pump handle. We saw Prime hit this last week.
Yes, he did. And but it cost him.
This time Alex Riley had it well scouted. And Alex Riley, I believe he's trying to expose now what's going on.
What is going on here?
Oh, Beverly's
got trying to give Alex a chair.
Well, that turnbuckle pad has been exposed. Beverly threw the chair into the ring. And now it's Johnny Prime with the chair.
Whoa. Oh, man, that's unjust. That's unjust.
Johnny Prime was caught with the smoking gun.
Your winner via disqualification, Alex Riley.
I can't believe that.
Absolutely not, but Dream Prime had the smoking gun, and that was a game plan all drawn up by Alex Riley. Distract the referee by exposing the steel turnbuckle, and then Beverly with the chair. Well orchestrated.
I want to tell you what, Beverly had a game plan. You know what I mean? That's pretty amazing.
She certainly did, and for the second week in a row, Alex Riley steals one from Johnny Prime.
Yes, he did.
My name is Steve Kern, President and CEO of Florida Championship Wrestling. My father was Colonel Richard Paul Kern of the United States Air Force, one of only two men in history, a prisoner in two wars. He was once asked in an interview, what was the worst torture he ever suffered as a prisoner of war? The answer? Hunger. The Metropolitan Ministries in the Tampa Bay area feed the homeless. Right now, there's over 20,000 homeless people in the Tampa Bay area, and the largest growing segment of that is families. If you have anything to donate food-wise, please donate to the Metropolitan Ministries. Thank you, and God bless America.
The following contest is a six-man tag team match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first the team of Trey, Chet Moretta, Kalen Brock, and Mr. Tarver.
Well, they wouldn't got him help, but they got Mr. Tarver.
The disguised duo, Croft and Moretta, teaming up with new danger, Mr. Tarver.
What are they now, boy toys?
Well, they have a bromance. They're deeply involved in a bromance.
Last week you said that was what you said last week.
Introducing their opponent, the team of Chris Logan and Florida Tag Team Champion, Tyler Rex and Johnny Curtis.
And as you can see, the championships are around the waist of their rightful owners, Tyler Rex and Johnny Curtis, teaming up with the multi-move Paragon, Chris Logan.
Hey, let me ask you a question. This is going to be a barn run, but you think Chris Logan, does he strike you as kind of some superhero?
Yeah, most definitely. Like Wolverine from the X-Men.
Well, he might have some superhero in him. I don't know. We're going to look into that as we future weeks coming up here. Well, as we are on the verge of what? The vacated Florida Heavyweight Championship. I cannot wait. This is going to be a good matchup right here.
Six-man tag team action. And there is no love lost between the Florida Tag Team Champions and Kalen Croft and Trent Beretta. A little mind games, perhaps, as it'll be Croft starting things out with Tyler Rex.
Well, I'll tell you another thing, too. Mr. Tarver there, one bad hombre.
And no emotion. I was wrong. It'll be Mr. Tarver starting things out.
Yeah, if I'm going to go get somebody to help me out, after these guys just in disguises try to pull a wool over my head, I'm going to go up and ask for help from Mr. Tarver.
So we'll see if Mr. Tarver can do the work for Kalen Croft and Trent Beretta. And watch out for Mr. Tarver, because one punch from him, the punch line, and this one could be over. Deep arm drag there by Tyler Rex.
Hey, what a rivalry that Johnny Prime and Alex Riley got going on.
It's heated.
Heated. You know, Beverly, she reminds me of a psychic major.
A psychic major?
I think that was what I was told.
I don't think you can major in psychicness.
Well, she knows what to do.
We'll see if Chris Logan can bring some superpowers into this matchup. Cover on Mr. Tarver and a kick out at one.
You don't want to blink your eyes right here with this young man in here, Chris Logan.
Chris Logan will do some amazing things. It'll make you want to rewind your DVR and watch it again to see if it was real.
Nice shot right there, Mr. Tarver. He's going to take care of a little business.
And now that Chris Logan's been warmed up, in comes Trent Beretta. Side headlock takedown there.
Got him hooked up, got him grounded. Let me ask you this. When you're a baseball player and you face a pitcher four or five times, you know everything about him, right?
Yeah.
This is the case with these four guys when I'm talking about the Florida tag team. And Croft and Beretta. They know each other, but you know something they don't know? How good Chris Logan is.
Chris Logan is the wild card in this match, that's for sure.
Yeah, yes. Absolutely, that's a point I was trying to make.
And Croft going for a tilt-a-whirl there into a backbreaker. And Johnny Curtis shots over with the leg drop. Cover by Curtis and a kick out.
Come on, get up, Croft, get up!
Chris Logan is working very well with the tag team champions.
You know why? I asked Logan earlier, you know what he said?
Cover by Rex and a kick out. What do you say?
You're going to believe this. He said it's a sideburn.
Chris Logan does have some pretty
Remember,
fancy sideburns.
Yeah.
And it's Logan up on the top rope double axe handle to Kalen Croft. And Croft with a handful of tights there. And oh! And Trent Beretta with the referee's back turn drives that boot right to the temple of Chris Logan.
Yeah, any way you look at this thing right here. Now, I'm talking about Tarver, Beretta, and Croft. Get a victory here. Somebody going to be still keeping their name in the limelight about, you know, Tyler Rex, Curtis, Florida Tag Team Champions, etc., etc., etc.
Ground and pound by Mr. Tarver. That's what he does best. That's the best way to stop Chris Logan. Right, Dream? Keep him on the mat?
Yeah, I would think keep him from high-risk maneuvers and keep him grounded. But he's a pretty fair hand on the mat, too. But he's in there with a really dangerous hand.
Mr. Tarver, a striker in boxing since he was just a little boy. Back suplex here by
he
Trent Beretta. Shoots the half into the cover and a kick out. Chris Logan needs to tag in one of the Florida Tag Team Champions.
It don't matter which one, right?
Both of them want to get in there.
Yeah.
And get their hands on Trent Beretta. The culprit, who we saw last week, steal the Florida Tag Team title. And then they had fake mustaches on, no less.
And we're talking like Frenchmen.
Well, kind of. They were saying French things. What do you have going on over there now? Want to know.
Yeah, take me out the ball game here with a highlight. Oh my goodness gracious.
Logan is on the wrong side of the ring right now. Catching a beatdown from three men. How is Chris Logan going to get out of this?
Well, I'm astonished at what's going on over here on the right, but that's all right. Well, he's in the wrong place first. Let's just start with that.
And Trent Beretta keeping himself between Chris Logan and his potential tag.
Yeah, hey, make no mistake about it. You know, Trent Beretta and Kalen Croft, they know what they're doing. And they got a guy like Tarver, and they can really turn the tide in this six-man matchup right here.
Beretta face first off the turnbuckle. And Trent Beretta wisely makes the tag to Kalen Croft. Chris Logan will not be able to make the tag. Oh, wait, I spoke too soon. Here comes Tyler Rex.
Wow, he's a moving and a grooving right here, buddy.
Tyler Rex all over Kalen Croft, like Dream said before. They know each other so well. And face first goes Croft into the canvas. And I believe we're going to see a little high tide elbow. American Dream approved.
Got it.
Cover, hooks the leg. This one is not quite over just yet.
Yeah, but he got a fresh guy. Got to tag the Curtis in here. What is this?
Look at this. It's like a wheelbarrow.
Yeah, a wheelbarrow flapjack.
Cover. And Dream?
What?
It's breaking down.
It's break it down. That's exactly right. Break it down to Tumble. The old saying for that right there. Got him hooked up.
Tornado DDT.
Wow, that was a pretty good move right there.
And here comes Chris Logan. There goes Trent Beretta. Kaelin Croft drapes his arm over.
They got him covered.
And Johnny Curtis hits the pin.
They beat Johnny Curtis.
Wow.
Here are your winners, Trent Beretta, Kaelin Croft, and Mr. Harbor.
Well, that puts them back in the hunt, young man.
You're absolutely right.
That Croft, puts them back in the hunt.
Beretta, Tarver take advantage of things breaking down and pick up the victory over Chris Logan and the tag team champions.
Pretty good matchup, though, man. They brought it. You got to bring it here, buddy. FCW, you got to bring it.
And speaking of champions, coming up next, we will finally crown a new Florida heavyweight championship. The title is vacant. Either Drew McIntyre or Eric Escobar will be leaving as champion tonight. And it's next. It's finally time to crown a new Florida heavyweight champion. There is a big fight feel here in Tampa.
Drew McIntyre, young man who's made a claim that he should be the Florida heavyweight champion. He's beaten everyone here. Understanding that, he will be against the former Florida heavyweight champion, Eric Escobar. This championship obviously vacated by Joe Henning.
Drew McIntyre told me earlier, Dream, that he's wanted an opportunity at the championship ever since Jack Swagger was the champion. This is Drew McIntyre's first singles match to challenge for the Florida Heavyweight Championship. And here comes a man who knows what it feels like to be Florida Heavyweight Champion.
Eric Escobar, on the other hand, so electric. Eric Escobar is so resilient. Once you've got him down, you're going to have to really continue to beat on him to even get a shot at beating Eric Escobar. So much at stake. Huge matchup. Unbelievable feel here in the FCW Arena.
The following contest, scheduled for one fall, is for the Florida Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first from Ayr, Scotland, weighing 19 stone, Drew McIntyre. Introducing his opponent from San Juan, Puerto Rico, weighing 255 pounds, Eric Escobar.
Well, we need to sit back and take a look because I'm telling you at home, you better get all your beverages and get everybody out of the other rooms at the end. Get them around that living room television, if you will, right here on the Bright Eye Sports Network. And watch this. It's going to be great.
Now get your popcorn ready for our main event. Eric Escobar, 6'3", 255. Drew McIntyre, 6'5", 260. So both men very similar in stature.
I'll tell you what it's going to boil down to right here is the guy that makes the fewest. Now, they can make a mistake, you know what I mean? Like I say to some guys, make a mistake not to recover. But these guys here, you can't make too many mistakes. And it's the guy that capitalizes on each and every mistake and becomes the Florida Heavyweight Championship.
Drew McIntyre also told me earlier that every night he thinks about the fact, and Dream, you remember this, Eric Escobar actually pinned Drew McIntyre to win the Florida Heavyweight Championship. It was a fatal four-way match. Sheamus was the champion. But it was actually Eric who pinned Drew in that match to become the Florida Heavyweight Champion.
That opens it up for Sheamus O'Shaughnessy, too. I mean, everybody's got a gripe here. Everybody's got a gripe.
Reversal here by Drew McIntyre. Eric Escobar off the ropes. Back elbow there. McIntyre quickly into the cover, hooks the leg, and a kick out before one.
Yeah, went for a quick cover. Got him. Drew McIntyre needs to go ahead and use his strength to stabilize this guy. Drew McIntyre's in tremendous shape. Both these guys are. But Escobar's the type of guy that, has a tremendous amount of resiliency. Is that the word? And keeps coming back no matter where you got him. So you cannot leave him. You know, that let sleeping dogs lie, it ain't going to work here, buddy.
Well, one of these men will follow in the footsteps of greats like Jack Briscoe, Jerry Briscoe, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, who held the Florida Heavyweight Championship on 8 different occasions. Steve Kern, Terry Funk, the list goes on. One of these men will add their name to that lineage of the Florida Heavyweight Championship.
And you go ahead and look at one of the most recent incarnates, the guy that is now the ECW Heavyweight Champion, Jack Swagger.
It is a stepping stone, there is no doubt about it, to be Florida Heavyweight Champion.
It's a big deal, buddy. Believe me, it's a big deal.
Side headlock here by Eric Escobar as we are settling in for a tremendous main event. And Drew McIntyre didn't want to wait there. Came up empty, though, and Eric Escobar remains in control. Side headlock takeover there.
Yeah, as you said, they're settling in, you know what I mean? But we need to go back and kind of recap just a little bit about how this came about for fans that are just tuning in. Bright House Network. Joe Henry became the Florida Heavyweight Champion. He beat Eric Escobar. The number one contender, Caval, was taken out by somebody who we don't know, is now in rehab. Joe Hennin came down with an injury, had to vacate the championship, and Steve Kern came out and signed this match. Now you are up to date on what you've seen right here.
And one of these men will leave here tonight as Florida Heavyweight Champion, either Drew McIntyre or the former champion, Eric Escobar.
Well, right off the bat right here, you know, the first few minutes of this contest, Drew McIntyre just put a steady amount of just pounding. You know what I mean? Not too much finesse, pounding him, trying to wear him down. Uppercuts like that right there. Take his stamina away.
Cover.
Get him in a position to beat him.
Every move so intent with violence by Drew McIntyre, and Eric Escobar fires back. A couple of shots to the midsection there. Eric trying to fight from underneath, which we've seen him do on countless occasions.
Yeah, he has no...
Another cover by McIntyre and kick out.
He has a tremendous will. I mean, the will for Eric Escobar is to win, and he has that. And you got to be born with that, buddy.
Big hip toss there by Escobar. A back elbow. And Eric Escobar sends Drew McIntyre out of the ring.
Got him out. There you go. There you go, Eric.
And Eric Escobar starting to turn it up here. Build some steam off the ropes. Baseball slide.
Wow. He connected with that one too, buddy.
Yeah, well, Drew McIntyre's head connected with the steel guardrail there. We're going to take a break. When we return, we'll have the conclusion of the Florida Heavyweight Championship match. Cover by Eric Escobar and a kick out. Welcome back to Florida Championship Wrestling. Josh Matthews alongside the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. This is our main event for the vacant Florida Heavyweight Championship. Drew McIntyre or Eric Escobar will leave with 16 pounds of gold tonight.
And during the break, Eric Escobar turned his thing around, got tired of getting pounded, and started doing a little stomping of himself, but it's been a pretty even matchup. It's hard to call right now.
Back and forth throughout. And Drew McIntyre sidestepped Escobar there. And now drives all of his weight right to the midsection, taking all the oxygen away from Eric Escobar.
Well, that's just putting a good game plan in, knowing what you got, you know, what the guy's going to do. Got him right here.
Kick out by the former champion, Eric Escobar, who lost the title to Joe Henning, who had to relinquish the championship. Here we are now, ready to crown a new one. A new era begins tonight.
Without a doubt, there will be a winner.
Now
Drew
McIntyre.
Grounding
Escobar. It's a good strategy, Dream.
Yeah, I think so. As long as you ground him, I think so. But I think you still have to power yourself, power your will on Escobar.
And Eric Escobar throws those elbows into the side of the head. McIntyre with the reversal. And Drew McIntyre once again with just body blow after body blow. Cover, hooks the leg, and a kick out.
Well, no matter what you say, them will take its toll. It's like being in a boxing match, seeing great boxers. They start working the body, breaks it down, your hands drop, your head opens up, bam, it's over. And that's what Drew McIntyre is doing right here.
And McIntyre just opening up Eric Escobar. And Drew seems pleased with what he's done so far. Calls himself the Savage Aristocrat, does Drew McIntyre.
This guy, Drew McIntyre, I'll tell you what, he's got more money than the law allows.
Yeah, that's what I hear. He goes for another cover.
You know, his parents does. I mean, you know, what's that guy, that young kid running around like Henry or Prince Henry?
Yeah.
Yeah. In Scotland, they say this kid can't go anywhere.
It's Prince Harry, actually.
Yeah, Prince Harry, yeah. Can't go anywhere. Paparazzi, people all over, they swarm him. And he's got so much money, man, that some say he can just buy his way into whatever he wanted, but he can't buy his way in here at FCW.
No, he cannot. I also understand that Drew McIntyre loves the nightlife. Doesn't look like he was out last night, though. He has a strategy here for his championship match against Eric Escobar. Should Drew McIntyre win, I got a feeling he'll be out in Tampa somewhere tonight, though.
Well, when Eric Escobar throws a party, as we know, the last time he won, me and you both were at it, he throws one, buddy.
I don't remember a lot of it, but it was fun.
You don't remember a lot of it? Uh-oh.
And once again,
yeah.
Drew McIntyre is not breaking away from his strategy.
Wow, relentless.
Just pounding on Eric Escobar.
Oh, man, he's taking that approach to where I'm going to use this guy's midsection and break him down and then go to the head. And that's exactly what Drew McIntyre has done.
But Drew McIntyre should know, I'm sure he does, that he can't let up on Eric Escobar. Drew, how many times have we seen Escobar in this situation and somehow, some way, he finds victory?
Yeah, quite a few times, but I'll lay this one on you right here. He's in a little different mode right now. He's in there with a big old stud, if you will, and he's really taking it to him.
Snapmare by McIntyre.
Stretching the abdominals right here. Working on the lower extremity.
And it all plays into the strategy that Drew McIntyre brought into this match, and that was wear down and work the body of Eric Escobar, who's trying to feed off of these fans here in the FCW arena.
Yeah, and your arm is not supposed to go like that. You know what I'm saying?
But Escobar back to his feet, and Drew McIntyre once again goes low.
Boy, he got
man's clothesline there.
Yeah, got Tap City right there. Duck under. Ooh. Wow, they both connected at the same time and both of them are down.
I believe we're witnessing the turning point in this matchup. Which one of these men, these athletes, will get to their feet first?
The crowd is really getting with it right now, brother. There he comes. That's a fighter. That's a warrior. That's a fighter right there.
I believe a light just went off inside of Eric Escobar. He knows that the Florida Heavyweight Championship is on the line.
Yeah, he's going to get it now. I'm bringing it. I'm going to take it.
This is a fight.
Yeah. Hard blow.
McIntyre up and down off the other side of the ropes there, and Escobar took his eyes off of his opponent.
Got to get him covered right here. What an impact Drew McIntyre took. Blouse out all up over his head almost.
Kick to the side of the
head.
There we go.
Got a hook.
New champion right now. Escobar with the cover and a kick out by Drew McIntyre. How did Drew McIntyre kick out of
Man,
that?
Unbelievable. Took the words right out of my mouth.
Escobar to his feet, as is McIntyre.
What a battle both these men have put up.
Either man can take the Florida Heavyweight Championship home tonight.
Whoa. Boogie woogie right there, buddy.
Escobar's down.
I'm not so sure about this move here.
We don't see Drew McIntyre go to the top rope that often.
No.
But with the championship at stake.
Yeah, why not try anything? If you don't try, you don't know.
And Eric Escobar is going to join Drew McIntyre from the high rent district.
Boy, he
and
is
look
up.
Look at that!
Wow, what a ride he took right there. Escobar has to cover him. He got him.
Super backdrop cover, new champion. How much, Dream, do these two have left?
Yeah, great contest. So much at stake. Unbelievable. This is FCW, Florida Championship Wrestling, at its best. You can't get better entertainment than this.
Short arm reversal. Scott drop coming. Escobar knows it. Oh, and Drew McIntyre went for it. And Presence of mind by Escobar, knowing where he was.
There you go, Josh. You got it. Good counter, man. Stay in the ring, Eric.
Hey, what'd I tell you guys? Bring it in here.
You can hear Drew McIntyre writhing in pain. Now they're on the outside. It's dangerous out there.
Wow. Buddy, he took a hard blow there.
I don't know how Eric Escobar's getting back to his feet.
Oh, no.
Scott drop on the outside of the ring.
Well, I think Escobar really took a blow, not only from his death, but that Scott drop right there. And he can't do nothing out there, but I'm talking about Drew getting back in. You cannot pin him out there.
Drew McIntyre simply needs to roll Escobar
back.
Here
we go.
Go for
the cover.
Is Drew McIntyre the champion?
He kicked out. He kicked out. Wow. Unbelievable. Eric Escobar.
You have got to be kidding me. McIntyre. Scott drop once again. There's no way he can
cut him after this.
Oh, we got a new champion.
Championship wrestling.
It took a Scott drop on the outside of the ring, another one on the inside of the ring, and Drew McIntyre is your new Florida heavyweight champion.
Wow, there's the picture and the future of our entertainment business right there.
Dusty, what a match we just witnessed, and we take another look right now as these two took each other to the absolute limit. But in the end, Drew McIntyre popped off with a Scott drop, and it was lights out for Eric Escobar. Ladies and gentlemen, Drew McIntyre is your new Florida heavyweight champion.